man knew that by the time he tries to take the choking baby to the hospital, the baby will die. So the Batman was left with an impossible choice to perform a tracheotomy on the baby by slicing the baby's windpipe to remove the ping pong ball from the baby's throat, and immediately rushed the baby to the nearest hospital, hoping that the baby doesn't die. As usual, the Riddler left another riddle with the baby for the Batman to solve. Now, while trying to solve and decipher the Riddler's riddle, he decided to link the locations of Riddler's past crimes, in which he will be able to pinpoint the exact location the Riddler's next act. The next riddle states, only one left, a little boy crawler. You will find lots of him, though shorter and taller, in which, due to Batman's investigation, he was able to discover the location of Riddler's next act, which was the House of Mirrors in a funfair. And due to his initial plan in going back to Riddler's previous crime scenes, which led to a peculiar location close to a place called Stockman's Square, in which, from his perspective, there was nothing special about this place from face value. Far away in Canada, Jacob Stockman still hears the voice of the girl they left in the basement with Barbatos. As much as she cried, screamed, shouted, and begged for someone to come to her rescue, no one came back for her. She was left to scratch endlessly and hopelessly till she had no more life left in her. She died. As Batman got to the funfair, where the House of Mirrors is located, he was surprised to see a goat coming towards him and wondered what the goat symbolizes. The Riddler's henchmen, who were armed with flamethrowers, began to fire towards Batman, in which he dodged stealthily, maneuvering himself with some acrobatic skills and also smashing all the mirrors in the room. But before he knew what was happening, the Riddler's henchmen had vamoosed. The only person left in the House of Mirrors was him, the goat, and the last of the kidnapped babies, in which he gave to a passerby to take to the police station while he goes after the Riddler and his henchmen at Stockman's Square, where he was being expected. He knows they are waiting for him, so he used the goat from the House of Mirrors as a distraction at the entrance of the building, taking advantage in knocking Riddler's henchmen out. Unfortunately for the Batman, the timber wood his slingshot was hanging on broke, for it was old, so he fell to the ground and passed out. Tired of Riddler's hesitation in getting rid of the Batman, in defiance, he tried to disobey his boss, the Riddler, by killing the Batman with his flamethrower, but was met with a surprise as he was shot by the Riddler, in which he questioned the Riddler's sanity in him shooting him for the sake of Batman. The truth is that the Riddler had other ulterior motives that was far more superior in just killing the Batman. He needs to be sacrificed, just like the human bat in the journals of Jacob Stockman. For the Riddler had been studying this journal diligently, believing in it, and for him, Batman was the only human bat that is qualified for the ceremony of the bat, as his intentions was to perform this sacrifice and gain control of Barbatos the demon. He wanted to finish what Jacob Stockman and his occultic friends couldn't finish. He wanted power for his own benefits. At first, a dazed Batman didn't understand what was happening, for he thought the Riddler was out of his goddamn mind. But the Riddler was serious, and that he was in his right senses, that everything he did to get the Batman involved was a process which must be done before the sacrifice at the ceremony of the bat. That although Jacob Stockman and his occultic friends tried to use a girl in form of a human bat as sacrifice. He decided to use Batman, and that without being aware of it, he made him go through the ritual process unknowingly to the Batman. Firstly, the human bat will have to kiss the lips of a hanged man, as the Batman gave mouth-to-mouth resuscitation to the hung security officer. Secondly, the human bat had to bathe in blood, as the Riddler lured Batman with his riddle to the blood bank, in which resulted in Batman covered in blood. Thirdly, the human bat has to dance with the dead, as the Riddler created mechanical dead bodies in form of zombies to attack the Batman. More of a dance, if you ask me. Fourthly, the human bat will have to stab a wild dog to death with a silver dagger. And that is why, when he was attacked by the dog at the bar, he was given a silver dagger in which the Batman used to kill the dog. The fifth ritual was that the human bat will have to slice the throat of a non-baptized baby, and in so doing, the Riddler stuck a ping pong ball down the throat of the baby, choking the baby to death, forcing the Batman to practice a tracheotomy on the baby by slicing the baby's throat. And lastly, the human bat does an acrobatic dance in the presence of the devil, in which the Riddler's henchmen forced Batman to do acrobatic maneuvers in front of the goat at the House of Mirrors by firing flamethrowers at him, as it is known that the goat horn represents the devil. And all these rituals led finally to the ceremony of the bat, where the sacrifice is made and he can have the capability of gaining full control over Barbatos, the demon, in the basement. In the basement, tied to the table, he couldn't move a muscle to release himself on time, and the Riddler proceeded to make Batman his sacrifice. The surroundings of the basement shook like it was experiencing a tremor, as the Riddler heard a voice saying to him that it could have easily possessed him, that he orchestrated and created the pattern in which the Riddler found the journals of Jacob Stockman in order to gain his freedom from the basement, that he rejects his sacrifice. So the Riddler asked the voice if he was Barbatos, and the voice said yes. At this time, Batman was releasing himself from the ropes he was tied in. Now, Barbatos now made the Riddler understand that he and Batman are one, are related, as Batman is the Dark Knight and he, Barbatos, is the Dark City, and that he had no use of the Riddler anymore. The Riddler, out of fear, ran out of the basement, locked it, leaving the Batman inside with Barbatos, and set the whole building on fire. Trapped in the basement, the demon spoke to Batman about the history of the basement, making Batman see what happened to the girl in form of a human bat, how she was drugged and made to do things against her will, just like the Riddler did to him, and how she was abandoned and left to die in the basement alone in the dark. Then the Batman asked who he was, and Barbatos replied that he is Gotham, he is the city, and that he shaped Batman to who he is today, despite the fact his heart had been locked in the basement for 200 years. He showed Batman the skeleton of the human bat meant for the sacrifice, and told the Batman that when the occultist summoned him and refused to go through with the sacrifice, he was trapped in the basement and left in limbo. But he was patient, waiting for the appointed time for him to use a man of riddles, who will use a set of riddles for a bat in which will enable his freedom. So he told Batman to free the girl who was still scratching the door at the entrance of the basement. Batman tried to open the basement, but Riddler had locked it from the outside. Then the girl asked Batman if he was Barbatos, the demon, and he replied no, that his name is Bruce Wayne. And what was her name? And she answered by replying, Dominic. Smoke was coming into the basement due to the fire, and Batman was confused on what to do, for they were trapped inside the basement. But miraculously, miraculously, the door of the basement swung open and it was Alfred, Bruce Wayne's butler, to the rescue. So in the midst of the smoke and fire, Batman wrapped Dominic with his cape, for his costume is fireproof, and ran out of the burnt down building, and the Riddler was nowhere to be found. Outside the burning building, Batman only rescued Dominic's skeleton, and he took it and buried her next to his late parents. As for the choking baby, Michael, he made it alive and was in stable condition. The one thing that still troubles the Batman is not the Riddler escaping, but what Barbatos told him in the basement, that he shaped him into who he is today.